The central banks of Namibia and Angola entered into a currency conversion agreement about 2 years ago for trading at the border towns of Oshikango and Santa Clara. The agreement enabled residents to exchange their national currencies for payment of goods and services. The Bank of Namibia, however, started receiving large amounts of kwanza, putting pressure on Angolan reserves, and the two banks had to put the currency agreement on hold. The Banco Nacional de Angola's governor and delegation are in the country and reassured President Hage Geingob of repayment commitment.
What the Angolan government decided is that we will continue to honor our commitment to Namibia despite the difficulties we are going through. We should be part of the solution by giving Namibia support, and that is by paying our debt.
With this month's repayment of 663 million Namibian dollars, Angola still needs to make additional payments to settle the remaining debt of about 200 million US dollars or 2.6 billion Namibia dollars as part of the repayment schedule. BON's deputy governor told the media that these payments would be done in installments of two this year and the others in 2018.
The payment has always been received on time, and as I have just said, that there are only four payments remaining, and payments are done according to the schedule.
The currency conversion agreement drew heavy criticism from some quarters of the society, especially in light of the current global economic headwinds. President Geingob says the skepticism was mainly raised over Angola's ability to repay Namibia's central bank following the drop in the price of its main export commodity, oil. The repayments, Geingob says, is coming in handy for developmental projects and foreign exchange reserves, given the current financial situation.
So here we are, two neighbors. We are having Namibian dollar and kwanza. We're using the dollar, American dollar, as the basis of cooperation. So we said, let's barter. When we did that, we were condemned, and things looked a little bit bad. But here we are, that he is reporting that it's working, you are paying, and we all, both of us, are in very difficult economic situation. Not because of our own making, but it's a global problem. I thank you very much for honoring the agreement and shaming those who are always looking for negativity when we are dealing with Africans.
The central banks of the two countries also revealed that the currency conversion agreement can still be revived once the economies recover. Blanche Kores, NBC News. Ventuk.